Okay, everybody. Hey, this is Frederick Jones, and you are watching the live video chat for Saturday AM. We're calling it Saturday Q&A Fight Night. So, so I want to thank you all for joining us. Hopefully, everyone can hear and see that we're here. We're going to be beginning shortly. Just want to make sure that everything is up and working. So, I'm going to be testing a few things, and then I'll run through a bit more about who I am and what we're about, and for those of you who are not familiar with us, of course. Hopefully you all are doing very well this Saturday night. I'm doing very blessed. I'm very happy with everything that's going on with my company and with our magazine and our creators, our original series. Just everything is going very well, so I couldn't be more happy right now, And hopefully, as we talk tonight, you guys will see that. And conversely, if you guys have questions, we're here to answer those questions also. And some people have already submitted questions in some of our groups. So I'm going to get started here. Again, if you just bear with me for just a moment, I'm going to make sure everything is set so that we can make sure that everything is where it needs to be. So. Okay. If you all have never used Google Hangouts before, and if you, hopefully you're on our website page watching the video, you can do a couple of things to post a question. You can do so via the Q&A app function, which is actually on the Hangouts module. So if you're using Chrome operating system or even Chrome browser and you've got the Hangouts API installed, then when you go to watch this video, it'll compete with it'll pull it in with YouTube and pull up that app, and you can communicate there. Otherwise, you can post a comment on our YouTube page, and you can likewise do so on our website, www.saturday-am.com. Last but not least, if you are a fan of our Facebook page, which is www.facebook.com/SaturdayAM, it's just one word, then you can go there and post comments there. If you are a member of our private artist community called Pilot Manga, you can post a comment there as well, and that's where we've got a few comments at. So, again, we're about to get started here very quickly, and so just bear with me as I just kind of... just ensure that we've got everything set up here correctly and everyone knows that we are live. So this is the nature of being a small company and having to do things with not a ton of resources and such. So you've got to kind of try to make things happen as best you can. But we've been doing this now for quite some time with our YouTube channel, and so things are moving along pretty nicely. So certainly don't have room to complain at this stage of the game. Let's see here. All right. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to do something I'm not a big fan of doing, but I'm going to do it anyway, which is I'm going to stop the video, stop the screen share, and I'm going to let you guys be able to see me directly. You can see me here. Again, my name is Frederick Jones. I'm the publisher of Saturday AM. You can see that I am indeed an African American. And you can see here that I'm actually sporting one of our Saturday AM shirts. So isn't that awesome? Isn't that fantastic? Saturday AM, baby. Saturday AM. Sport it with pride, ladies and gentlemen. Normally, when I'm doing these meetings, I like to do them with the power of a glass of wine, but I'm actually not doing that tonight. I'm actually using some Starbucks coffee. Likewise, my dog is in the background, so you may hear her bark or something. Hopefully she doesn't. But nonetheless, again, my name is Frederick Jones. I'm sporting our Saturday AM t-shirt, and I'm the publisher of Saturday AM, which is a digital manga anthology. It's very similar to Shonen Jump or many of the Shonen magazines in Japan. It's similar. It's inspired by what they do, but certainly it's very different. We, of course, are not Shonen Jump. We don't have the money that they have. We don't have the lineage that they have. Our objective when we started the company, and really two key objectives that I've been upfront about since the very beginning of starting the company, was number one, diversity. That is at the absolute core of who we are as a company. I spent over a decade in the video game industry. I worked on some very big properties from Yu-Gi-Oh! And so on. You know, for me, it was something very important, almost spiritual, that during my career, some of the things that I experienced personally, that we have a company, that we have a company dedicated to producing frontline mainstream content. Not, you know, we don't produce companies called Black Man or Brother Man or what have you. We want to create content that was original, that was unique, that would look like content that other people would publish. We wanted to have characters of color, and we want to have creators of color. So we wanted to have two facets of that where people could feel that this was a property that was A-plus in terms of the sort of ideas it was communicating, but it was also relevant in terms of the world that we live in. So, you know, you could not be reading something and say, wait a minute, I live in a neighborhood with Black people and Latino people and other types of Asian people, but I'm reading a comic book story that only has Asian people or only has Japanese people and only has white people who maybe have Japanese names. And so, you know, I feel very strongly about that and have always felt strongly about that. And so part of the DNA of Saturday AM was that we wanted to challenge that. And we've done that. We've inspired, and we have so many young people who have written us really powerful letters. At some point, we'll actually share some of those letters, but about how they never believed that someone who looked like me or looked like them could produce manga type content. And so we take it very seriously. You know, we have encountered our fair share of haters who dislike us for a variety of reasons. They dislike me. They dislike the company. They dislike White Manga, one of our superstar artists. They dislike, you know, Saturday AM, the name. I mean, like, they dislike everything. But while I'm old enough, and I'm much older than most of the people who complain about us, to know that this stuff comes, you know, whether you're Jay-Z or you know, back in the day before he became big time, whether you're, you know, Seth Curry, you know, I mean, whatever you are, when you are a person trying to do something big, you have your fair share of haters, people who just don't want to see you succeed. That's fine. You deal with it. What I've never understood, though, is when we're talking about something that really is about equality across the board, you know, people who traditionally do not get noticed or not get promoted in manga in particular, and you're going to hate on us for that, I find that amazing. But, you know, nothing surprises me at 41 years old. Number two, as part of our DNA, as alongside of diversity, is this whole idea of producing content that is capable of actually sustaining itself as an industry. We are a digital manga anthology. So again, you know, while we kind of structure what we do like Shonen Jump, we're not Shonen Jump. And as a result of that, one of the things that is kind of fascinating is that, you know, our entire objective has always been to create a methodology for people to make webcomics, to actually make money. And again, this is one of those things where, you know, what we're trying to do is very revolutionary, because the traditional way of webcomics for a very long time has been one of two things. Either as an individual, you set up a site, you tell your friends and family about it, they come to check out your website, they come to read your comic books, and then maybe you can, you know, have enough advertising to justify what you're doing, or you can go to a show and sell, you know, tchotchkes of those characters if they're popular enough, or you can, you know, get up some sort of licensing deal. Someone sees it and says, hey, we want to make a cartoon about it like an Axe Cop. But those are, you know, those are kind of like moonshot opportunities. They kind of remind me of the idea of if you are someone who loves rap music and you're like, well, I want to be a rapper. Well, the reality of you rapping in your household or in your local neighborhood and then going to be Jay-Z are like astronomical. The same way that the idea of you becoming a soccer player like Cristiano Ronaldo or Lionel Messi, you know, is astronomical. It's just very, very difficult to have that. So it's a moonshot idea that you could do the webcomic stuff on your own. We've had many creators who have decided they want to do it on their own, and some have not really progressed much anywhere, and some have had some opportunities. But at the part of our DNA, the core of our DNA, we started Saturday M to have diversity, creators and characters, and to create a actual platform where creators should be able to make money. And so one of the ways we do that, of course, is, you know, merchandise. You know, we just launched our brand new store called Saturday M Marketplace. It's going to have a host of webcomic-based material there that people can enjoy, from T-shirts to prints to trading cards, something that has never really been done before from webcomic creators, at least not in the way that we're doing it. And the biggest thing, of course, are books. And so we have come out to date with two books. You can see here they're very big. One is Apple Black, which is one of our blockbuster titles. See here, very, very strong. And I'm going to talk about Apple Black here in a minute because, again, you know, haters, you know, I normally try not to respond to haters, but, you know, we're a small company, so when people hate on us and then use misinformation, which potentially damages us, to me, I find that kind of libelous, almost kind of like a lawsuit type of thing. Not that I would sue anybody, but I do find it amazing that people would say things and think that they're being a fan or a customer or a journalist and say things that are so completely untrue or that lack any sort of actual investigation on their end that the only purpose of it is to try to do us harm. And I find that amazing. It's like, you know, if we succeed, then everybody wins, whether you're with us or not, you know, because we're making a pathway. So to try to tear us down, particularly when you get to lie about it, is astronomical. Saigami, our second book that we came out with, is beautiful as well. You can see here that unlike a lot of webcomic books, you know, these have branding, they have professional trade dress, and the quality, which is one of the things that I wanted to address, and of course you maybe can't see it so well, you can't see it too well, but the quality of these things are really amazing. You know, we're a small company, it's our very first time doing it. Apple Black, when it first came out, by being our very first book and being our biggest book as well, did have some issues. You know, there are some issues that we addressed actually relatively quickly. You know, I was on Amazon the other day and read some comments from people. Now, this is back when it came out, which was almost a year ago at this point. But I was amazed at some of the comments that were made. There was one guy in particular who really, you know, I'm not listed on Amazon's page about Apple Black. I'm not listed on Saigami's page about Saigami. You know, I'm the publisher of this material. I'm the guy who started the company. I run the company, but you know, at the end of the day, like I'm not a celebrity, I'm not a superstar. So when we advertise our books or our products, you don't know anything about me. I don't make these videos very frequently. So I was stunned at how there were a handful of people who kind of came together to attack us and attack me personally. And I find that astonishing. And so they made some comments about Apple Black, which frankly, you know, are offensive. You know, they suggested that, first of all, this was really poor quality. As a 41-year-old man, I grew up in the 1980s, in the late 1970s, 1980s. I can remember buying Kamiko, First Comics, Mirage Comics, Mirage Studios, I mean, which made Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I remember buying comic books, and again, a lot of you guys are very young, but it is astonishing to me that when I bought these comic books and paid a lot of money for those comic books back in the 80s, that they had spelling errors. It was routine for DC and Marvel to have color issues. So you might be reading a panel where you've got Spider-Man, and in one panel Spider-Man's glove is yellow instead of red, or Batman's glove is yellow instead of blue. That stuff happened. And perhaps it's because we didn't have the internet. Perhaps I would have. I mean, I never did it. I never complained about it. It was just the way it was. It was comic books. You were there for the artistry and for the stories that you couldn't see anywhere else. Perhaps I think, again, that it's something to do with the age of some of the people who complain about this stuff, because the reality is that I highly doubt that they're doing this to Apple. One of the guys who wrote a really nasty note about me, again, I have nothing, I'm not listed on the page of Apple Black, but he really went to town on me in particular. I find, you know, like I said, I went to go look at his listings of things that he's reviewed in the past. He hasn't reviewed anything. He's reviewed nothing. He just made it a point to get Apple Black to attack us, to attack a Kickstarter that we tried to do last year regarding Saturday Wars, which we'll talk about here shortly. And I just, again, this is stuff that happened months ago, and so I didn't even know about it. But it's just, I find it astonishing. I was literally tonight on Facebook, I got a link from someone who wants to become a part of Pilot Manga, who referred us to, I mean, who linked to another webcomic. And it was a guy who was the writer of this webcomic. It's beautiful artwork. I won't say the name of the company because of the webcomic because, you know, I don't feel like I need to. But I was amazed because the guy who was in our Pilot Manga group, the writer and creator of this thing or whatever, you know, someone said to him, like, hey, man, this stuff looks really good. You should become a part of Saturday AM. And he wrote back, like, well, you know, no, we're not going to do that, you know. And then he said, he goes on to say, the guy who runs it, he and I don't see eye to eye. You know, I can't deal with his ego. And I'm literally reading this thinking to myself, who is this guy? Because I don't remember talking to him. Then I went back, and, you know, the internet is for a lot of you young guys, the internet is hell for you guys. Because a lot of you guys sometimes, I think, forget what you actually say and that it's being located on the internet. I go back and look at this thing. This guy joined Pilot Manga at the end of last year, early part of this year. He joined Pilot Manga, our exclusive community for amateur artists, something that we've got open for everybody, whether you want to be a part of Saturday AM or not. You have to request to join. We let you join, and then just try to be a good steward of the community. Try to follow the rules and support each other. And this guy comes in. He doesn't follow the rules, and we give him a warning. And he gets upset that we gave him a warning, which we do for everybody. And then he does it again, and then we kick him out of the group because we're like, you know, that's just the rules. And so with that exchange, literally someone who I didn't know about, forgot about totally, someone who didn't follow the rules, and this is all documented, he decides to take that, and this note happened last year on his Facebook fan page, and then suggest that the reason he's not a part of Saturday AM is because he dislikes me, that my ego got in the way of him when, like I said, it's in black and white on our YouTube channel, I mean on our Facebook page. He just didn't follow the rules, and we had asked him politely to follow the rules, and he got indignant because no one tells him what to do, I guess. And then he, you know, is now decided during that period to start spreading a falsehood. And, you know, so I come back to the whole DNA of our company and the idea that what our objectives are to make an industry where webcomics currently do not have one. And the second thing is to try to bring diversity to the table. To me, whether you like, you know, our creators or you like our brand or you like me, those two goals that we have are something that I would imagine should stand for everybody. Everybody should be able to embrace more diversity. Everybody should be able to embrace somebody in the webcomic space trying to create a way for creators to make money, whether it's coming up with professional-grade books, whether it's coming up with merchandise, whether it's coming up with a brand like Saturday AM. Whatever it is, you know, what we try to do is trying to benefit everybody. And again, if we fail, you know, it only hurts everybody. Hopefully someone else can do it the better way. But if we win, then everybody wins, whether you're with us or not. Because once webcomics are taken seriously, if your webcomic is sitting on another website or you're trying to do it on your own, everybody wins. People are going to look at you in a different way because Saturday AM was successful. So, you know, I've dealt with that sort of hatred, that sort of kind of mindless reaction to people who are trying to do big things. And what we're trying to do is revolutionary. People have gotten upset about that, but the two things that I always tell my artists and our creators is that I have yet to see someone call me a liar, because I don't think they're going to do that. But if I am so out of line, then someone just needs to call me a liar and point to where I'm lying. Number two, I have yet to see where any of these guys, despite how much they've misinterpreted the truth, I have yet to see any of these guys who hate on us show me where what we've done is indicative of what some other webcomic did. Saturday AM, our flagship magazine, digital magazine, featuring original content every single issue, We just recently launched our 32nd issue. Next weekend, the September 18th, we will come out with our 33rd issue. No one else has done that. No one else has done that. I want to repeat that. No one else has done that. Does that make me proud? You damn right it does. Does it make me tired? You damn right it does. We have busted our butt for that. And so the reason I open this video up with this whole hater thing is that I think that the damage that's done when people act irrationally and try to misinterpret the truth, try to hurt other people, is we just had an experience about this with one of our Saturday Plus creators, a young girl named Regina Akora. And she's producing a really beautiful romance comic called TOONAMI Life. We're testing it, and hopefully you check it out. We'll talk about that more in a second. But the reason I wanted to lead off with this is that, you know, when haters come at you or at, you know, something you're trying to do, not only are they exposed themselves and not harming your particular goal or mission that could be something that's benefiting everybody, but they serve to do something even more disgusting, which is to hurt people like Regina Akora and other young creators who are putting themselves out there, who are trying to produce something new. They're trying to just live a dream. They're not trying to make money. They're not trying to make friends. They're not trying to. They have an idea. They want to get it out. They want to share it with the world. And for that, whether you like what they've produced or not, whether it's the best looking thing that they that someone could do or not, the sheer fact that someone is willing to sacrifice their own personal fear to give something a chance, they're willing to there in face of fear, the sheer reality that someone is doing that deserves all the respect in the world. And to shatter that dream for someone who's completely new, who's completely trying to get themselves out there, trying to see whether or not this is something that their voice even works in the world of storytelling or webcomics, comic books, to shatter that individual because you just want to pick fights. I know this is the internet. I know that's something that, you know, we see this on every comment page, on every website, and so on and so forth. But I'd like to think that the people who follow and believe in what we're trying to do, or the people who simply want to, you know, kind of follow in our footsteps, would recognize the disgusting aspect of that and say to themselves, you know what, this is not worth it. You know, I don't want to be known as somebody who would destroy someone else's hopes and dreams just because I want to pick a fight because I'm bored tonight. You know, this hater aspect of people has really got to stop. And you know, we're trying our best to produce great content. And you know, if we were wealthy like Jay-Z and Beyonce, then I can assure you we'd be doing this. I'd be doing this. But our guys, our creators, sacrifice time with their families. They sacrifice time with their children, their loved ones. They work jobs or have careers that pays their bills while they're trying to do what they do in the webcomic space. And for that type of sacrifice and dedication, it deserves a bit more than petulance. It deserves a bit more respect and appreciation than trying to, you know, showcase how awesome you are and then blaming other people for why you've not actually done what you believe you could do better than us or better than that individual. So I wanted to start off with that. You know, I've taken, you know, on myself as an African American who's gone through corporate America and dealt with all sorts of bigotry and racism and prejudice and things that I've had to deal with in my career. I am more than capable of dealing with the sort of silliness that goes on as it's directed to us. I have no problem standing up to it. But as I said, we're trying to inspire a lot of young creators, and we've inspired a lot of young creators around the world of various colors, sexual orientations, nationalities, religions. And I'll be damned if the work that I've done, the sacrifices I've made, will be deducted or will be reduced by people who really don't have any real positive merit in what they're trying to do. They just live to destroy. I'm not going to have that happen. I refuse to have that happen. So if you're with us, then you're with our revolution. If you're with us, then you support Saturday AM. You support diversity. You support trying to make a path for a real industry out of webcomics. And whether or not you think that I'm arrogant or that I, you know, that how dare I talk as if I know what I'm talking about, I'm 41 years old. I've got a career at this stuff. You can look me up. I do find it also kind of comical. A 20-year-old, you know, thinks that I'm arrogant because I have a background of accomplishment, and they don't like to be told. I don't know why that is, but regardless, you know, we're here to stay. We're here for the long haul, and all of our creators who are with us are with us, and we're not going to stop. We're not going to stop until we've made this brand and these books and our creators successful artists who can pay for their livelihoods, who can have a livelihood, pay for their families, and live their dreams. We're not going to stop until all that happens. So that's that. That's the beginning of this wonderful video. That's why it's called Fight Night. I'm sure this will engender some comments on our YouTube channel, and I don't give a damn because I'll respond right back. So let's get started. Let's talk about our latest issue. Let's talk about Saturday AM and what it's all about for those of you who are new. And let's answer some questions that come through. I'm now going to switch it over to screen share. Again, I want to thank you guys for indulging me with that little bit of Freddy talk time. But now let's get back to what really matters here, which is Saturday AM. You can see here at the top, if you've never seen us before, we are located at www.saturday-am.com. And we have Saigami, which is a fantastic comic book from a creator out of Hungary, a female creator named Andrea Otilia Voros. It's the young girl sitting there in the corner with a beautiful flame in her hand. I can tell you that Andrea is easily one of the best artists that I've ever seen. Her stuff is phenomenal. And more importantly, I can tell you that Andrea is one of the most loveliest people that I've ever had the pleasure to work with. You know, to be in webcomics, again, you can have a very confident personality like I do, or you can simply just be a really loving, incredibly cool person, and that's Andrea. And Saigami is something worth checking out. It is a fantastic series. If you love series like Inuyasha, you owe it to yourself, or Legend of Korra, you owe it to yourself to check out Saigami. Many of the content for Saigami is on the website right now for free. Next to her, here, the guy who's got his finger kind of saying, come on, that is Bully Eater. And that is from Raymond Brown. He's one of the co-founders of Saturday AM. He's been in with us since the very first issue. He was also one of the very first creators that I contacted to join this radical idea that I had. Bully Eater is like Street Fighter. It is fun. It is just kind of like a fun fighting action manga. I think, you know, people really love it when they have a chance to check it out. Raymond's a really swell guy, and just a really cool book. To the right of that, underneath the Saturday AM sign here, the gentleman wearing the kind of Tommy Bahama button-up shirt and shorts is Turbino. He's from a webcomic that we have exclusively called Islanders. Islanders has a unique place with us because it was discovered by us. It was produced for the first time by us. Leonardo Massif, the creator of this, is from Cuba. He is a really, really magical guy. He is someone that I find him to be a real pleasure. He's fun. He's a big guy. He's fun. His design sense, his ability to create characters is literally second to none. There are professional artists out there who are a rare breed who can produce really amazing character designs. Leonardo, to be like all the other Saturday AM creators, an amateur, produces some of the most insanely fun and kick-ass character designs you'll ever see. Islanders is funny, it's action-packed, it's kind of like One Piece, except it's a little more mature, and the characters, like all of our series, operate a little more realistically in the sense of their personalities are a bit more ironed on than some of the stuff you see in traditional manga. But God knows, if it could ever be as big as One Piece, we'd be rolling in the dough. Finally, here you'll see that Apple Black, that's Sano from Apple Black, he's a star. He's arguably the biggest manga webcomic in the world. It is insanely popular. White Manga, the creator of it, is insanely popular. It was one of the biggest decisions that we made, making that offer to White and having him come on as a founder at the very beginning. He hasn't disappointed. He produces a story that is fantastic. The character designs that he has are incredible. The originality of just the plot and the uniqueness of the characters and so forth are stunning. And what makes it just all the best is that white manga, Odunze Agogo, is Nigerian. He is a African Nigerian, a black African Nigerian from Africa. And when you see his work, you do not think anything but a top-tier level Weekly Shonen Sunday, Shonen Jump, Weekly Young Jump, Jump Plus type of artist. You think the top tier of manga creators in Japan, but it's not. It's from a guy out of Nigeria. We're so honored to be the exclusive home of Apple Black, and so we just love what we're doing with these core series. But the reason we're having this chat tonight is that the last half year, I've been working to expand that group and bring us titles that further fit the overall DNA of what Saturday AM is all about, and brings us a level of diversity both amongst creators and amongst characters. And so we had a promotion this summer called Summer of Manga. It began in issue 24, and we debuted many manga concepts that will be running eventually inside of Saturday AM. Monster Society of America by Christopher Crady will be coming in issue 34. It is a horror seinen type of manga. No to Heaven, which is from William Brody. That is basically a survival horror type of series. So think like Walking Dead or even Attack on Titan. That's about Judgment Day and the end of the world and humans who decide, you know what, we're not cool with this. We want to fight back. That's going to be big. It's going to be really big. And there are several series, but the most popular one by far was a title that I created. I created all three of those titles I just mentioned, but there's a title I created called Clock Striker. And Clock Striker features a young girl named Cast. You can see here issue 32. This actually was the first Summer of Manga title that we previewed back in issue 24. It was the very first one. It had the cover feature of issue 24. And Clock Striker is a series featuring our first African-American female lead. Now, let me just say that of all the titles I just mentioned, we have, all of them have minority leads. Monster Society of America with Christopher Crady features a multicultural cast. The lead character of that, the hero of the story, so to speak, the anti-hero actually, is a young Latino kid named Anthony, or Ant, and he's with a Dominican girl named April. A biracial girl named April. We have a Dominican girl named Serenity, who will lead up the multicultural cast of No to Heaven. And with Clock Striker, what we have is our very first African-American female character named Cast. And she is the lead character of Clock Striker. She's a precocious 12-year-old. She is super cool, really fun. And in this story, the basic idea is that Cast wants to become a forge master. And forge masters in the world of Clock Striker are engineers or inventors. They solve problems, basically, through the power of invention. And you can easily make a case for forge masters and what they do with engineers in Silicon Valley. Cast, just like engineers in Silicon Valley, by being a young woman and being a young woman of color, and being a young person with a disability, which is her hand, she is completely dismissed from actually, being considered a serious contender to become a forge master. And so her struggle is one that is faced by many people of color and many women on a daily basis. And her struggle is simply to succeed in the face of doubt. And on top of that, of course, we have action, we have adventure, we have really cool gadgets and technology. And the reason she's called the Clock Striker is that in this world, if you look at the old world of blacksmiths who were early engineers and inventors, to be an apprentice to a blacksmith, you were called a striker. And so I took that name when I was developing the concept and decided, you know what, yeah, so Stryker, but it needs something better than that. And so when I created her mentor, who was the character that she would be traveling with and going on adventures with as she learns her trade, I came up with the character of Philomena Clock. And Philomena Clock is an older, mysterious woman. She kind of looks like Mary Poppins, except a very severe Mary Poppins. She's got this huge clock medallion that she wears, and she is not at all what she seems. She is feared. She's legendary as a forge master. She's one of the few women forge masters that exists. No one really likes her or trusts her because she's so odd, but she has a really interesting backstory, and so Cast becomes her apprentice, and therefore Cast becomes the Clock Striker. And so that's the basic idea behind Clock Striker. We just debuted the first part of her three-part story in issue 32. It was tremendously successful. The reviews and comments have been stunning that we've received for it. And so we're just really pleased that so many people have embraced not just, you know, the character, but this black female, this young black female. It's just for me in particular, it just is something that I feel very positive about and very happy about. So what I'm going to do real quickly is answer a couple of questions about this and then answer some more questions that have come in as well, talking about some of the other things that we have coming up very soon. I'm also going to be talking about Pilot Manga and our upcoming test flight. So as of right now, let's hit a couple of questions before we move on, and we'll go through all the questions as time continues here. So one of the questions that was there is in regards to, let me see here. So let me read some of the comments here. There was a thread that came a little earlier here. And so let's see. One of the thread was started by Kamani Jackson. He asked, he says, so I wanted to start a chat about Clock Striker thus far. I feel it has a lot of potential in the style and art, story-wise. I think chapter one was well done. I got this formulaic vibe from it and also gave us tons of information about that world. The writing was really well done, in my opinion. Thank you, Kamani. Would love to hear other opinions. And so he received a couple of opinions. One was Andre Roberts, who says that he thought the art really complemented the story and that the entire thing had so much originality, unique aspects to it. He thinks it becomes something really massive. And Andre, we hope so too. We certainly hope so. Kinshaw Michaud said that he thinks this that the setup thus far seems like something that would come straight out of Shonen Jump, which is a huge compliment. As I said before, you know, we're not in competition with Shonen Jump. We are inspired by Shonen Jump, and so the sheer fact that we that we could even exist or have something that sits similar to Shonen Jump is a huge compliment. He says, you know, the artist really nailed the Shonen style, and Frederick's dialogue is on point. I love how the characters are interacting with each other. Even with the twist of the protagonist being a black female, it still manages to feel authentic, which is something I really admire. I was a bit let down with the previous release of Mass Multiplayer World of Ghosts, which is a series I'll talk about here shortly, but Monster Hunter Society and Clock Striker have really surprised me. Frederick L. Jones really knows how to get you invested in a story so early on. If it continues past the short story, I could definitely see it becoming Saturday AM's biggest title thus far. So let me comment on a couple of those things, and then we'll get to a couple of questions. So, you know, over the last 2 years since we launched this, we're in our second year, we've had a number of titles that were with us, and for whatever reason are no longer with us. Either we needed to move on from that creator, or that creator needed to take their story on. Race On is a good example. Mythalka Lux Nova is a good example. You know, I, being the founder of the company, had, when I started it with a project called Massively Multiplayer World of Ghosts, which is literally just, you know, kind of meant to be like an MMO meets Harry Potter meets Tron, you know, with some elements of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure in there. And I started out with Eric Michael Ella, who was one of our early creators, and Eric was, you know, moving towards trying to do his own thing, which was PoseBots, and so it just became really difficult to continue with that, so we postponed it. Then I had a second artist out of Brazil, a young, very young person, who then started college, so we couldn't continue on with him. Then we had a young man here based here in North Carolina who had an art style I thought was pretty decent. It was very different. It was more cartoony, but it didn't fit. And so, and then we were looking at another individual, and that just didn't work either. So Mass Multiplayer Rugos has been somewhat cursed because, every time we try to get an artist to help tell the story that we really think is could be really huge. I mean, take Pokemon, make it more badass like Avengers, and then, put it together kind of like in a story that's kind of big and action-packed like Transformers. And, you could really have something special there from action figures and toys and video games and so on. We just haven't been able to lock down that artist. And so, so I've kind of put it on the back burner because I want it to be consistent. And that's one of the challenges you have in webcomics is that it's really difficult to launch something unless the artist and the writer are the same person, because the writer has a very clear sense of what they're trying to do. The artist is trying to feel their way through it, and conversely, both have to be dedicated to all the sacrifices that you make making a webcomic regardless. And so therefore it's really been easier when you've got two creators. When you've got one creator who's doing both jobs, but what we found, and I've seen this personally with Mass Multiplayer World of Ghosts, is that, you've got to really knock it out of the park in terms of finding a suitable artist who gets you, who gets what you're trying to do, who buys into the idea and is willing to support it. And we've got that with Christopher Crady for Monster Society. We've got that with William Brody with No to Heaven. And Clock Striker is just a perfect example of when those two things came together in the right way. So Clock Striker, we debuted that. We're just going to run in issue 32, issue 33, issue 34. And we just wanted to kind of see if people really come to it. If it does, then we still have to finalize things with this particular artist. But if we can, then we'll bring the series out completely in 2016. We'll bring the series eventually regardless. But, again, we want to try to avoid those issues with artists. And it's a very difficult thing when you're trying to get an artist to work with you and finding the right artist, finding someone who's dedicated to the art regardless, and things like that. It's not easy, but we think we can pull it together. If you are interested in checking out Clock Striker, you can do so. Again, it's issue 32. In the issue, you get Clock Striker, you get Islanders, and you get Saturday Plus, which is an entirely separate magazine right now where we're having it joined with Saturday AM for premium subscribers or for people who purchase the comic book. So if you buy just the individual issue of Saturday AM for $1.99, you get Saturday AM issue number 32, and you get Saturday Plus number 9. And when you get Saturday Plus, what you're getting is our three titles being serialized in every issue, and these are pilot chapters of series that we're trying to test out to see if people will like them. And these titles are TOONAMI Life, which is by Regina Okor, as I mentioned earlier. It is Explosion Joe, which is by a young man named Yende Hall. And it also includes a title called Chained Black, which features art by James Attilo. So I can show you some images here shortly of those series of Saturday Plus. But here's Saturday AM. You can see again that we take our branding and our quality very seriously. And it doesn't always work because we're a small company, and if the big companies can have infractions, then so can we, and we certainly do. But we try very hard to produce quality content, so we've made it to 32 issues not by accident. But you can see here the cover for issue 32, and as I scroll a little further, now you can see here some of the art. This is some of the art from Clock Striker. You can see her; she's talking to Philomena Clock. And she's showing off an invention that she has that's going to play a role in the next installment. You can see here some really, really wonderful art from Leonardo Massa for Islanders, the latest Islanders, which is in issue 32. And this is Turbino, who can control water. He's going to fight this Navy lieutenant who's just insane named Celia Reyes. And it's a brutal fight. It's also very cool. You see he's got these water cannons all set up here. As we scroll down, you now see the cover for Saturday Plus, issue number 9, which is what you get when you purchase Saturday issue number 32, or you subscribe at the premium level for $25 a year. You get Saturday Plus number 9, and this features on the cover here, Atomi Life. Atomi Life is a romance featuring a lead character who is from India. He is a Bollywood star. If you're familiar with Indian Hollywood, he's from what they call Bollywood, and he has come to Australia, and he's kind of out of the whole romance genre, which is where he became a superstar, and he's here, and he meets this girl that he thinks is actually pretty amazing, except she's really into video games. She's into romance video games. So it's like a cross-media, cross-international love story or challenge, love challenge, and it's awesome. And Regina Core is fantastic. And so we really, really like Atomi Life, and I think you'll like it too. So if you want to check out an amateur shoujo series that could eventually become something within Saturday M or on our website or our magazine, you should check out issue number 9, check out Atomi Life. Likewise, I hear some panels from Explosion Joe. You can see Yinde is a very competent artist. This is about a young teenager who is a superhero and a spy, and he's got the power to control explosions. So this is a really cool, interesting concept, and we're really excited about it. Again, Yinde, someone who's got a lot of talent. Whether or not Explosion Joe is going to be the series that he is able to turn into a big hit, we don't know, but I think this is a fantastic series. I think if you're into Cartoon Network type shows, you should be checking out Explosion Joe. And last but not least is Chain Black. You can see here it's got some stunning artwork. The artist of this is super young, so the fact that the artwork is so polished and so mature is astonishing. This is a series which is very different. It's about Asgard, the land where Thor and Heimdall and all those characters live. After Ragnarok, which is, if you follow Norse mythology, that's the end of the world. And so that's come, the gods have all disappeared or died, and so it follows this character named Kara, who's the girl you see here glaring at the very bottom of the panel. She is a Valkyrie, so she's one of those female warriors who didn't actually graduate from Valkyrie school, so she's kind of like a bit of a screw-up, but now that the gods are all gone, she's all that's left to try to protect this devastated land. And so this is all three of these series are just pilot chapters, meaning that we're going to run it over a couple of issues, tell the first chapter, essentially, and then we're going to evaluate it. And you all can evaluate them as well and tell us if these stories actually are worth us continuing to promote and support and turn into series. How can you do that if you do not subscribe? How can you do that if you don't buy the individual issues? These will all be made free towards the middle run of the series. So in the next another issue or two, as we approach October, you will start to see the content get serialized on our website. And so if you come to our website and you click on Read Manga, then you're taken to a place where those series will eventually end up. And you can see here all of the manga that we produce. Not all, but most, and eventually all. Some stuff will eventually get serialized here. And so as we scroll down here, in fact, I've got to change this here. This is the old latest issue from issue 30. You can see here a beautiful cover by White Manga for Apple Black. So that's actually a plus for those of you guys who are tuning in. But you can see here we have all these series here that you can just click and start reading. So there's Apple Black, there's Saigami, there's Bully Eater, there's Spoon, which is this really amazingly fun series that if you love webcomics, if you love like old 1980s independent comics like I do, whether it's Usagi Yojimbo or Gru or just some of these awesome kind of battle sort of comic books, you need to check out Spoon. Spoon is fantastic. The artwork's very eclectic. It's different, but you're going to love Spoon. It's one of the best written comics that we have on the site. You've got Storybook. You've got Z Forever, which is hugely popular. You've got Comet Man, which is kind of like an all-ages title. Storybook, by the way, again, is one of our oldest running titles. We've got 35 chapters that you can read right now for free. It updates every Monday. Remedium Plus is one of the newer series, again, coming from our exclusive pilot manga community. It features a young exorcist, kind of, who also has kind of got some medical training, and he has to figure out whether he can cure or whether or not he's going to damn the people who are afflicted with spiritual demons. You can find short stories in our test run. You can read the original Mass Multiplayer World of Ghosts. Saturday Plus, you can click and check out some older issues of that. Eventually, that's where some of the other Plus titles will end up when you click this little button here. Posebots, Candlejack, Oxcane, Dreamwalker are some of our one-shot titles you can check out. And then Roughhouse and Wanted Dead or Dead are two amazing series that are currently on hiatus. And we hope they come back. We have them exclusively, but whether or not the creators come back, we hope they will, because these are really talented people with really fantastic stories. But this sort of content is all free, and there's not, as you see, a ton of advertising for you to have to deal with. So we really take very seriously our role in producing original manga webcomics, our role of having exclusive, specific creators to produce original content that is unique and original and doesn't look and feel like everything else. So we're really proud of what we've built. And of course, anchoring all of that is our digital magazines, Saturday AM and Saturday Plus. And so one of the questions is about, you know, hey, I've got a great manga. I'd like to join you guys. How do I put my stuff up on your site? So so I'm going up here to the navigation when I'm clicking Pilot Manga. And Pilot Manga is the something that we created to essentially speak to where we are in terms of looking at new content. And the reality of our situation is that we are too small to deal with submissions that are unsolicited. And so what that means, of course, is that, you know, just because you have an idea for your title, just sending it to us, you know, sight unseen, never having talked to us, just we can't go off of that. You know, we have things that we look for, things that matter in terms of how we structure our team and our group and our creators. All of our creators are carefully picked. All of our series are carefully picked. And so, and we're just too small to try to support everybody. We're not some of the traditional manga web comic sites where you basically have a free opportunity to just upload your content and have people check it out while they make money on advertising and you just basically hope to get an audience. We don't want to be set up that way, and we're not set up that way. So so we're not that, and we just can't accept every idea that someone has being sent to us directly. So what we came up with was Pilot Manga, and Pilot Manga is, at the face, it's a community. It's a community dedicated to original manga webcomic creators who want to commiserate and share and get feedback and just basically be inspired and encouraged for their passion of wanting to create comics. It does not mean that you have to produce content for Saturday AM. And that's traditionally when we have to remove some members. That's traditionally one of the reasons why, is that they basically joined it just so they can tell people to go check out their comic on another website. Since we, you know, are trying to build what we're trying to build, and because we try to keep the group pure so people aren't stealing ideas or stealing each other's art, which does happen on a lot of websites, then we try to put together a list of rules that say, hey, you know, respect this group's sanctity. If you want to join another group on Facebook or another private group that you can talk about manga and share ideas and tell people to check out your book, there are plenty of groups for that. But we want to create a group where you're really encouraged to take your work seriously and to be viewed seriously with your work, to share and commiserate with other people who are trying to do the same thing you are, versus trying to just get people to check out your comic. I find that personally not offensive, but I find it kind of I do find it a little offensive, and I'll tell you why. Because the way that that is done strikes me as an odd situation, because you have gone to another website to upload your comic book. So again, if you went through Pilot Manga and you went and joined the contest that we have to actually get critiqued and get, you know, the feedback from some of our guys who've been doing this for a very long time, and myself, who's done high level stuff for a long time, if you were seeking that, then you go through Pilot Manga. If you're seeking just to basically shout to everybody, hey, I have a webcomic on this other website, the thing I find out about that is that the first thing that I should tell you is that, why did you join that other website? If they're not promoting you and you've got to go to that length to get people to check out your webcomic, then that says something about the site that you put your stuff up on. Like that can't be a positive that you have to go to us, which, by the way, we probably have less traffic than those websites do. So to come to us to get people to check out on our private group at that, so it's not even our website, our private group, so you have to be a member of it to even see it, and try to promote your webcomic on another website, it doesn't speak well to the way that you're able to comprehend things, and it doesn't speak well to the website that you put your stuff up on. Like, it just doesn't make any sense. So at the end of the day, that's kind of the deal. I mean, we actually put Saturday Plus up on another website just to try it out, and it was so trivial, the sort of things that we got, that we just said, you know what, we're not going to put anything else up there, because if we don't get anything out of it, it doesn't do anything for us. And so, you know, so I understand the mentality, and we're talking about potentially having a special day where everybody who is part of Saturday AM Pilot Manga can just share their stuff. So right now, you know, we have Sundays, Tuesdays, and Fridays where you can upload your artwork. And on Fridays, we prefer it to be Fan Art Friday. So, you know, you can do fan art of some of our characters, and we'll promote it all throughout our network. So it can be good, big exposure for you, for your art, things like that. But we're tinkering with maybe making an extra day outside of those three that would be dedicated to sharing where people can read or check out your work. And so we're thinking about it. We're gonna advise on that at some point soon. But that's the basic idea for right now. But if you join Pilot Manga, you have to request to join. My recommendation to you is to have a Facebook page that shows us that you actually are an artist, because, you know, Facebook is full of spam, and so the last thing we want to do is set up is admit somebody who is literally like a sex bot, or is somebody who's, you know, there to try to steal artwork and stuff. And again, those things happen more than you know. So we want to just, you know, not have that. So we try to screen every member that comes through there. We've had literally nearly 1,000 people try to get in, and we're at about 300 and maybe 90 or thereabouts. So just keep that in mind. If you want to get into the group, be sincere. Really be interested in trying to share what you're doing, both the criticism that you would get as well as the compliments you get. Because again, if you're just there to try to say, hey, go check out my website, then then you're gonna maybe talk ill about someone else's work and say, you know, you're not good here, you're not good there, your anatomy's wrong, this and the other, then that sets up a negative relationship in our group immediately, because people won't take you seriously. And we see this all the time. There are people who come in our group and they try to say, hey, go check out my YouTube page, or go do this or go do that, or, you know, you need to do this with your art, or you need to consider this, and they've never submitted anything in a test flight. And you know, we get those comments from other members who say, wait a minute, you know, if you're not serious enough to try to produce your own stuff and be critiqued or really put your stuff out there in one of the contests, then why are you talking as if you are an authority on something that I need to take you seriously? And so, you know, again, if you have a community, everybody's equal. But if you are kind of sitting in a lofty perch and attacking people, and you're not actually in a position to show what you're doing on your own, or as some creators or some Pilot Manga members have said to us, they don't like to take criticism, then that's not a good place to be. You're not going to make it in the webcomic space if you have a thin skin like that. Same thing with the young man who attacked Regina Okorah. I mean, one of the things I found hilarious is that when he was saying that Regina Okorah's artwork wasn't as impressive as we had said in marketing copy, you know, he then went on to say, well, he's too lazy to actually submit anything. And I just thought that was amazing. So regardless of whether you think that Regina is a great artist or not, and she is, by the way, to attack her, and then when you're called out for your own lack of material, you say, well, I'm too lazy to submit something. Like, that's the sort of stuff that, you know, back to the whole hater comment, they just, the webcomic industry is too full of people like that, and it needs to get more dispersed and be full of people who are trying to do something. Even if you try and fail, which Pilot Manga is all about that, you know, we want people to come in and be serious and give it their all. And you know, if you fail in one of our contests or you get some negative feedback, that's how you grow. But the fact that you have the courage to put yourself out there says more about you and about your future ability to succeed in life in general than those who don't submit and put themselves out there. Those who are not willing to take the arrow that they're so happily willing to throw at other people. So, Polyp Manga is a community. We screen all the requests for membership. But if you want to become a part of Saturday AM, don't send us your comic book. Go through Polyp Manga. That's the best and fastest way. And again, we look at everything. We try to evaluate you on every possible aspect. So take it seriously. If you come in and you're asking questions because you didn't bother to read the rules, it makes us unable to take you seriously. And guys, again, for those people who would say, oh my God, that's so arrogant, that's life, man. That's, again, you know, I'm 41 years old, I had a corporate career, that's life. You can't get a job. You know, the example I give is that you try to go work at McDonald's and you tell them, hey man, what's cheeseburger? They're not going to take you seriously. And that's McDonald's. You know, I like to think we're better than McDonald's. So, you know, that's the problem. You know, a lot of haters out there. You gotta grow up. Stop being haters. So that's Polyp Manga. I'm going to read some more questions, and then we'll come back to the contest, and I'm going to reveal for the first time news about test flight. Again, if you have any questions or comments, you can post them. You can do so on our YouTube page. You can do so on our Facebook fan page, which is www.facebook.com/SaturdayAM. And you can do so in just a variety of places. So, you know, in our Polyp Manga group, you can do so via the chat window of this particular YouTube video. So you got plenty of room, plenty of places you can do it. So please post questions or comments. I'm going to read a couple now that I saw. So it's from Chichulu Hernandez, who's one of our long-time members of Polyp Manga and a phenomenal artist in his own right. Chichulu Hernandez asked, he says, what do we think about a crossover of characters from Saturday AM publications? So, like, for example, a Spoon versus Comet Man or something like that. And So the answer to that is we actually are doing this. We actually debuted the idea of this last year. We had a Kickstarter last year called For Saturday Wars. Saturday Wars is our big manga webcomic crossover. It features all of the characters from Saturday AM, all the series that currently run within Saturday AM, both the website and the magazine. It will include some of the series who come from Saturday Plus, and it's going to at some point be open to some people in Polyp Manga. So whether or not you've actually ever been in Saturday AM, you will have a chance to actually have your character drawn by either a professional and or one of our amazing manga creators like White Manga or Raymond Brown or Andrea or Leo or so on. You can have a chance to have your characters in Saturday Wars. Saturday Wars is an original graphic novel. It'll come out as a Saturday tank from the get-go. It will not be serialized. We might, you know, we're going to certainly do some marketing for it, but it comes out around May 2016, so there's lots of time. I expect us to debut some art and a trailer for it by the end of the year. So plenty of time for you guys to get excited about it. But we decided to, we tried to do a Kickstarter for it. It didn't work. We didn't get the money we needed to get. We were trying to raise about $10,000 to go through all the things that we needed to do with it, which, again, was one of the hater attacks that I saw on the thing. The guy actually called out our Kickstarter when he was attacking our Apple Black book, which I thought was amazing because it has nothing to do with Apple Black Volume 1. And, in fact, it was because we did the Kickstarter and it didn't work and we realized that, you know, that we simply would not be able to afford all of the top things we wanted to do in terms of getting additional outside non-Saturday AM help to edit and proofread and QA and all that stuff, that we had some of the issues that we had in Apple Black. So, you know, to attack us for it seems awfully silly because it was like, you know, the fact that it didn't work is exactly why the first volume of Apple Black had some problems. But, you know, again, being a small company, we've learned very quickly. Our tanks now, I would put up against anybody's tanks, whether or graphic novels, be it a major publisher like Yin or Viz, and or any webcomic person who decides to do it on their own. these are really quality books. They've been beaten up by me as I read through them, or I hand them out to people we're hoping to do some business with. So I can tell you that we're very proud of the work that we do. We always see room that we can improve, and again, at my level, I'm looking at, you know, things that are kind of invisible to the average reader of our stuff, in terms of quality issues and bigger quality sort of unique assets that I want to do for some of our books. But you know, I'm not a fool. I know that where we started and how small we are, that what we've produced to date is damn good. And so hopefully you can support it. I'll talk more about the books in terms of if you purchase it on a store, you can save money versus Amazon. So hopefully you keep that in mind. But yes, we will be doing Saturday Wars, and a couple of you will be able to participate in Saturday Wars with your original character. So do stay tuned for that information. That we'll be talking about that later in the year. Adonis Rael responded to that comment and said, it would be really cool to do a crossover for all the different characters, although the results of their battle would most likely be indefinite. They would either stop fighting, have a draw, or get their fight interrupted. So, Adonis, let me actually respond to that and say that I'm writing this, and I own this company. So I'm not privy, despite, again, what some of our hater legion like to suggest. I don't play the ego game, and I made that very clear to a lot of our creators. It is, you're right, it is definitely a challenge. Image Comics, Rob Liefeld, Todd McFarlane, you know, Jim Lee, they kind of ran into this problem where they kept trying to outdo each other. I remember when they launched the Image Universe, it was all connected, even though none of the guys were working together in that way, or at least it didn't look that way. And so you had Spawn, who was the most powerful character in Image, and then Rob Liefeld, you know, who was creating all these kind of like throwaway characters for his series, decided that he was going to create Supreme. And Supreme initially was horrible. It was just Rob Liefeld, in my opinion, is not a writer at any level. But he eventually got Alan Moore, the great Alan Moore, to write Supreme. And Supreme turned to be a hell of a book. In fact, turned to be a hell of a lot better than Spawn. But regardless, that sort of one-upping of each other, just because, you know, well, I'm a creator and I'm popular, and you're a creator, you're popular, but, you know, I want to have the more popular, I want to have the more powerful character, more powerful than your character. That sort of silly horse trading, you know, I was very reluctant for when I first developed the idea for Saturday Wars. So I made it very clear to all the creators that, you know, I'm going to be writing the series, I'm going to present their characters the way that I think their character needs to be presented. So, you know, I think if you like Clock Striker, if you like Monster Society, if you like No to Heaven when that comes out and you can have a chance to see how I write, I think you'll be very, very happy. The characters who, you know, who should be what they are will be what they are. And the characters maybe who haven't been as defined as they could be will be. And it's, I'm really proud of it. I think it's going to be, I think it's going to be a book that will get us the sort of notice and respect from the press that to date we've not gotten, because I think it's going to be just a crossover that sits up there with Valiant and, you know, DC and Marvel and all those guys. I think it's going to be a really solid crossover of all these different brands brought together in a way that is realistic and fun and action-packed and threatening and all those good things that you want to see. But Saturday Wars is coming. It's coming in May 2016. I think you guys are going to love it. And, again, you'll be able to participate in it. So that is that. So again, I think there's some questions or comments. If you have them, please feel free to post them. But right now what I want to do is I want to go into talk about Pilot Manga here and talk about specifically the test flights and test run. Now, test flight is our main pathway to experience Saturday AM, to become a part of Saturday AM. And what Test Flight does is it allows us to set up very specific tests, very specific guidelines that we expect you to adhere to. And by doing that, what it affords us is the ability to essentially have a look at the creator as well as the concept. So we're not interested in having your 40-page epic one shot for your series that you know is going to be a blockbuster. And we hear this all the time. We literally hear that all the time. You don't have any data to say, well, it's going to be a blockbuster, but you know it. It's not something that you guess, you know. And I'm saying that sarcastically because you don't know. But nonetheless, you know, that sort of milieu is what we try to break down. We try to break down that ego. We try to break down that kind of cluelessness. And we try to focus the creator into a series of tests that actually test them as actual creators. And so, again, you're not going to be submitting something you've already done. Most likely, you're going to be tweaking it. You're going to be trying to, you're going to be creating new material that fits the test. And what we do then is myself and usually one or two other creators within Saturday M, we have a very long and very big discussion about that. And you can see here on Pilot Manga, you have all these videos. You can click the link and watch the video discussions about those test flights that we performed. So again, test flights coming up very soon. It's in fact, the last one of the year will be in October. None of these will be series that we look at potentially for 2015. We'll look at them for 2016. But I do want to announce tonight that the next Rules of Test Flight will be made available this coming week on Wednesday, which Wednesday is the 16th. So I will post the new rules on Wednesday the 16th. It might be in the morning, it might be in the evening, so just be patient. But what I can tell you today exclusively on the Saturday Q&A chat is that the test flight will give will be focused around coming up with a literal short story. And by short story, I mean just a handful of pages. I don't want to say the number right now, but it will be very brief. And for that short story, if we like it and we think that it meets all the criteria and you follow all the rules that will be as a part of that short story, we will publish it exclusively inside of a special Christmas issue of Saturday AM that will be made available to you and your friends for free and will be made available for purchase on comixology.com as well as our website. So we are very excited about this. We did a Christmas special last year for subscribers of Saturday AM, and it was very cool. This year, we want to do the same thing. We'll have also content in it from some of our Saturday AM creators, both the website and the magazine. So it's going to be a very unique sort of publication, and it's going to include content directly from amateur creators who are in our Pilot Manga Test Flight contest. The rules will go up this coming week, and you'll have until mid-October to get us that material in. We'll put together a big video, we'll evaluate them, and then should we select them, we will have those titles appear exclusively within the Saturday AM Christmas special, which will come out obviously in December. So again, perhaps that may inspire a couple of questions, I don't know, but that right there is a major thing that we're doing that that you know, I just wanted you guys to know. So with that being said, I did want to talk next about test runs, but I think there were some questions that were posed a while back. Let me take a second here and talk about Marketplace, just a little ad for us. As I said before, you know, our part of our DNA is diversity. The other part is creating a pathway for success for manga webcomics. And again, we decided early on to not be a place where we had a lot of creators who produced content for our website and that we made advertising, that we made our money off of just advertising for them. So it's kind of the Facebook model or the model of so many sites where they call it crowdsourcing, where you basically power the site because you put all your content up there and then we make money on the advertising. We went a different path with that. So no amateur creator is sitting inside of Saturday AM, for that very reason. Like that's meant to be the creators who A, can sell people will actually buy their work, and number two, these are creators that we are featured creators that we know follow the ethos and the professionalism that we require for Saturday AM. But on our website, which also has the same sort of standards just in a different way, we don't have advertising there to essentially make money off of their backs. So the marketplace was a way to help provide for our creators, and hopefully we hope it catches on and becomes something major for all webcomic creators. Eventually we'll open it up for all webcomic creators, but the key thing here, if you look on our new marketplace, is that we have these amazing exclusive designs that you can't find anywhere else. So Saturday AM, Apple Black, if you want to have a really funky Saturday AM logo shirt like this one, you can do so. Look at this design here. This is from Christopher Crady, artist of the upcoming Monster Society. And look at that awesome design. It's like the famous Saturday AM logo, except the foot is crashing through the T-shirt, crashing through the logo. It's awesome. It's really awesome. You can get that shirt for just $20. So again, our marketplace is an original home for original Saturday AM product that you can only find on this website. So if you love Apple Black, it's the only place you can get that Apple Black logo tee. If you love Spoon, this is the only product right now that you can buy for Spoon. Look at that logo, designed by Raymond Brown. The Comet Man logo, which is one of my favorite logos by Raymond Brown for our amazing all-ages series Comet Man, you can have that logo. Likewise, we have a series of graphic tees. These are T-shirts that feature our characters or statements and things that are completely just inspired by Saturday AM. And so there you've got Sano from Apple Black, what we call a doodle shirt. You see Ayumi from Saigami next to him in a very beautiful shirt. Then you've got Ant, the lead character of Monster Society of America, with his two spirit bats. And he is looking awesome. Keep Calm is Saturday AM. That shirt's actually proven to be very popular. Another beautiful Saigami design. Bully Eater, Fight Hard, Win Even Harder T-shirt. This awesome Hero in the Making shirt for Z Forever. You can get these shirts exclusively, and every 2 weeks we'll be adding to the store, adding to these T-shirts, and some of those designs will come from our Pilot Manga members. So again, it's another reason to join Pilot Manga. We may not have a space for your manga, or we may not think your manga is right, but if you're a great artist and you've got a great design and you submit it, we'll run it, and you can make money. You can also find our Saturday Tanks. If you remember, I showed you the covers of Apple Black and Saigami, and the key thing here to keep in mind is that with us buying the book from our store, which is be the print editions, by the way, we're talking the print editions. If you buy Apple Black on Amazon, it's $13. You buy it from us, it's just $8. If you buy Saigami Volume 1 from Amazon, it's $8. I think it's $8.99, actually. If you buy it from us, it's just $6. So why would you not shop at the store for books of our favorite series? Next up is Bully Eater, Volume 1. You can pre-order it today and get the physical book when it comes out in October, mid-October. You can get it today for just $5. Now, eventually, a pre-order will stop, and you'll be paying regular price for it. So why would you not? Saturday Wars, the crossover event that we talked about, is coming in 2016. But today, actually not today, but it's coming soon. We're in the process of finalizing production on it. You can get Saturday Wars trading cards. When we launch this product, there will be two packs that you can buy, a pack A and a pack B. Pack A will have four cards, including one bonus rare card that you can't find, that, you know, it's randomized. And the second card set, pack B, will have four cards, and will have one card that's super rare and random. So you're guaranteed to get almost a complete set by buying both packs, and then you may get, you know, two different rare cards, in which case there's going to be a few more. But this is really huge. On the back of the cards, by the way, is all this unique data that tells you what to expect in Saturday Wars. So it's already setting the stage for Saturday Wars. So this is something that I'm really proud of, because you do not see this. You don't see this. You don't see webcomic creators doing this. That's not to say webcomic creators are stupid. That's not to say webcomic creators aren't smart. We're not saying that. We're saying that when we talk about the revolution that we're trying to do, this is what we talk about. That's what revolutionary means. It means you're trying to do something that other people just don't do. Trading cards of our characters. And let me tell you something. We intend to have 100 cards in the set. So you can do the math and say, well, if I get four cards and four cards in the second pack, so I buy both packs, that's only eight cards. And maybe I, and then I get two rare cards, and let's say they're actually different from each other, then that's, you know, 10 cards. If you think about every series that we have in Saturday M, and then series that could come into it, like Atomi Life or Chain Black or what have you, with all those characters, it's still going to be kind of difficult to get to 100 cards. So how are we going to get to 100 cards by this time next year? Once again, Pilot Manga members will be able to have their characters who are selected to appear in Saturday Wars. We will also do a trading card of that character. And you, the creator, will receive that trading card. You can show it to your friends. It'll be professionally produced like all of our products. And so you can, that's something you can have for your personal accomplishment. Not just being in a book that's going to be sold in a lot of different outlets, and a graphic novel produced by us, featuring artwork by all of our top creators and one really amazing creator who's not connected to us. You're also going to get a trading card that talks about your design, your character, and features your artwork. That's a pretty big deal. That's a pretty big deal. So we're really proud of Saturday Wars trading cards. Each pack is just $10, so you can do the math. It's about $2 per card. So we have more stuff that will be coming onto the marketplace, more stuff. So that's not it. We have more stuff coming. The next update will be this coming Saturday alongside of issues number 33. So if you've not bought a shirt, remember, you buy a shirt or you buy one of the books, you're supporting our creators. It's that simple. You're supporting our creators. So one of the challenges that exists for webcomics is that a lot of people don't take it seriously. And one of the problems for webcomics is that here we are taking it very seriously, deadly seriously, and some creators don't like that. We're too arrogant, and we take ourselves too seriously. It can't be both. So if you want to actually make a career of the webcomics, then support us. Support our creators. That what level that is up to you. You can buy a t-shirt for $20 to $25 to nearly $30 depending on your circumstance. You can pre-order Bullet Eater for $5. You can buy Apple Black for $8 or Saigami for $6. You can buy a pack of trading cards. You can subscribe to Saturday AM and get 20 issues a year for just $5. Or you can subscribe to Saturday AM for our premium subscription level, get 20 issues of Saturday AM, get direct early access to issues of Saturday Plus, get some of the trading cards, including one of the rare cards, and get a t-shirt. You also get discounts on future Saturday AM purchases. So we take our marketplace very seriously. We're extremely ecstatic at the marketplace. We think it's awesome. So if you want to support our creators directly, please do. But it all begins, if you want to be featured in the store, it all begins with Pilot Manga. We're going to go back to Pilot Manga, and we're going to wrap up by talking about the test run. We will do that in just a moment. I want to address more questions that we've got. Again, if you've got questions, you can post them. I'm Frederick Jones, writer, creator of Clock Striker, founder of Saturday AM, the magazine, founder of My Footprint, which is the publishing entity of all of these titles, Saturday AM, Saturday Plus, the website, and so on. So if you have questions, post it on our Facebook fan page, which is www.facebook.com/Saturday AM, or you can post it on our Facebook, on our Pilot Manga group, which is actually featured as a private group in Facebook. You can do it on the Google chat function if you have the Hangouts app. I think it's called Q&A. And you can do it on our website or the YouTube page where this video is being hosted. All right. So we're going to talk about Test Run here. And in fact, for that, I'm going to go back and read manga. But also, I'm going to check here for some of the questions. There were a few questions that came through the pipe there as we were talking. So allow me to pull that up while I'm pulling up the page here. Oh, well, Dennis Rael said that he was really, really appreciative of the response I gave regarding regarding Saturday Wars, and he was excited about it last year. He's excited about it this year. He's even more excited. Andre Roberts said that he would like to audition for Master Multiplayer World of Ghosts. I appreciate that, Andre Roberts. We probably will be posting something about that soon. So just stay tuned for that. Let's see here. I think there was some other comments here. We have a comment here from Jatulu Hernandez, who again is one of the young men who has been in our pilot manga for some time. One of the best things about pilot manga, I have to say, is that we have discovered some really amazing talent. So I do find that that's something that's a feeling that makes me very proud, because some of the guys that we've discovered for Saturday AM have come through Pilot Manga. They've never produced anything before, and so it's really amazing that we get to experience their work, that we get to discover them. All right, so what I'm doing right now is pulling up Test Run, and so that should be coming up here very shortly. So we see here Test Run, and what you're looking at here is Monster Society. Now, Monster Society was an original Test Run that I produced. This is a series I created, and we had artwork from Christopher Crady. And Test Runs basically are another way that you can have your work evaluated to a degree with Saturday AM and then be considered for a chance to be featured on Saturday AM. Now, there's a couple of ways to look at Test Runs. First of all, and more importantly, Test Runs are meant to be short stories. And so what we ask in short test runs is, unlike test pilots, where we give you very specific rules, test runs, we give no rules. There are no rules except that, it has to be clean. You can't have sex or graphic violence and things like that. But it has to be just a basic story. You're just telling a story. But you do have to do it within 15 pages. And herein lies the rub. This is what makes test runs such a powerful and something that only Saturday M could do, is that it really puts the onus on the creator, because I think one of the challenges that webcomics have is that too many creators think they're creators when they're really not. And I talk about this a lot, and some people get bent out of shape about it, but, to me, if I didn't say these things, I would feel like I'm misleading you, because I'm not telling you the truth, and this is nothing but the truth, even though it's brutal. And so by that, what I mean is that webcomics can't advance when it has the mentality and the perception of being fanboy content, of being someone's imaginary Naruto or Dragon Ball Z story. And that can be blatant. That can be literally blatant, where you're just posting a comic book idea that the character looks exactly like Goku, except instead of having yellow hair, he's got red hair, and instead of a orange gi, he's got a yellow gi, That would still be very blatant. But he's from a planet where he's the only character, where he's the only good hero, and he's got to try to save his adopted planet. We've seen those submissions. So that's one aspect of it. The second aspect of the 15 pages and what it helps to do is curtail the opposite end of that spectrum, where you, instead of having fanboy content where they're literally just trying to do a kind of blatant or semi-blatant ripoff of a popular manga series, is the guys who actually are fanboys in the sense that they've got all these amazing ideas, but they never actually sit down and tell the story. So when you give them something like 15 pages, you see that they struggle because they can't actually tell the story. They don't know how to tell the story. And this is something I say a lot. And again, people can get ticked off about it. I don't know why anyone would get ticked off of these things that are just kind of common sense. But, the reality of producing creative content is that for artists, if you do not like to draw, like you're looking here at the first page of Monster Society of America, we were looking at some bleachers. We're looking at a kid running down a hall. We're looking at a hallway. It's got a bunch of lockers on it. We've got a kid reaching the door and it's trapped. We've got a guy coming out of a room. We've got the light behind him. Even the lettering here. If you do not like to do this stuff, or you don't like to do it in those circumstances, you will never be a sequential artist. And keep in mind what I said here. I'm not saying you won't be an artist, because you can be all sorts of artists, but you won't be a sequential artist, because to be a sequential artist, you have to actually enjoy filling in all those details and doing stuff that's not just Superman punching Bizarro. You've actually got to, you know, do the things that tell the story. And those things can be mundane. They can be tedious, like filling in the tile of a tile floor. To be an artist, you have to do those things. To be a sequential artist, to be a comic book artist. And to be a comic book writer, to be a writer at all, you have to write. I can't tell you how many people we get who talk about being a writer, but they don't write. They don't write blog posts. They don't write. They don't do interview. They don't like interview people for their website or for another website. They don't. They don't write. Even if they find an artist who's amazing, they don't actually write a script. They just kind of like have a general idea that has no real end to it. It's just like a series of like random things. And you know, but if you ask them about the story, they give you a ton of backstory about how amazing the story is going to be 5 issues later. That is not how the real world works. And that's why we take the tactics that we take when we do our reviews of things. We're very brutally honest. I don't, and again, some people have an issue with that. And because I do all these, some people have an issue with me. They had an issue with Simon Cowell on X Factor and American Idol. But this is not about trying to hurt somebody. This is about, you know, I mean, again, you know, I walk the walk. So I can talk the talk. So if you're going to be a writer, you better be writing. You better understand the mechanics of writing. You better be able to start a story and end a story. And so test run is ideal for the people who don't want to do test flight because they know their story is going to be awesome, but then it puts them in a scenario where they've actually got to tell their story in 15 pages, not 10 pages and not 17 pages, 15 pages, period. You can do a cover with that in addition to the 15, or you can not have a cover and just have the 15 pages, but you must tell the story in 15 pages, a beginning, a middle, and an end, and a scene that's just like a fight sequence doesn't work. We actually had a test run that we approved some time ago that the more and more we looked at it, the more we realized it's just a fight scene. There's no story there. There's no plot. There's an idea there, and some of the artwork is decent, but it wasn't a story. So test runs are another method, and I'll say as well that if you remember Pilot Manga and you submit a test run, not only will we consider it, not only will we run it, but you will also be privy to the opportunities that exist for test flight. So if it's fantastic and we think it's really good and the consumer, people who read it on the website think it's really good, then we will look at the character and say, hey, let's add this character to the trading card set, and let's add this character and concept to Saturday Wars. But if it's not, then we won't run it. And if we do run it, like all of our other series, we expect it to be exclusive for a period of time. So that is test run, and again, you're looking here at pages by the great Christopher Crady, who's one of our Pilot Manga members, who has now become a full featured creator of Saturday AM, who will be taking this particular comic called Monster Society and turning it into a regular series that you'll be able to read only in Saturday AM. The series is going to be hot. It's going to be hot. Multicultural cast. Think the CW and like a show like Supernatural and manga or anime. Just something that's got some real style to it like manga and anime, but is very Western and very adult in a teenager way, not in the kind of shonen way. So we're really excited about the series. I think it's going to be huge. It's going to be action-packed. So I think you guys can get into it. All right. So hopefully that answers the questions on test run. Test runs, whereas test flights, the rules will go live next Wednesday, and then submissions will begin shortly after that and run until sometime in October. Test runs are always open. You submit it. We review it. We advise you whether or not we're going to run it, and then we run it. We do some marketing stuff around it, and you get to tell your friends to go check it out. And it's as simple as that. We don't do an extensive review of it, by the way, because again, we're too small. So we reserve our extensive reviews for test flights because that's something that we're really looking at a lot of statistics there, a lot of data we're trying to compile and understand the creator and the concept. Whereas in test runs, you know, we're not doing that. So the positive is that you don't have to go through a lot of the rigmarole. The negative is that you don't get to get the sort of review that the other guys get to get from test flight. So that is that. So again, I'm happy to answer some questions. I will go for another, let's see here, it's about 1:15. I'll go for another 15 minutes. So if you got questions, get them in now. Let's take a look and see what other questions we have here or comments we have here. If you've got them, please feel free to post them in our Facebook fan page, www.facebook.com/SaturdayAM. It's one word. You can do so on our website. You can do so on our YouTube channel. You can do so as well in our Pilot Manga group if you are already a member. So Kimoni Jackson posted one to ask about test run, which you just talked about. And he said, I want to know more about the process post-submission. So once submitted, when will it be up on the site? How do we know if it will be on the site? So again, you know, I did kind of answer this, but let me give a bit more detail. Like I said, we've always, you know, kept in touch with the creators, let them know, and it's usually within like a week or two period once the webcomic comes in, and we review it. And again, once we air it, it's 30-day exclusive. Now, if we never air it, then you can do what you want to do with it. But we let you know almost within 5 days, we let you know whether or not it's approved or not, and then we go from there. As far as the process in terms of running up on the site, you know, we let you know, we put it up on the site, then we let you know exactly where to locate it so you can tell your friends and family to go check it out, and we encourage people to post their comments. So again, one of the things about the internet is that, you know, you do expose yourself once you put yourself out there to people who just don't have respectful or tactful sort of view of creation, and they may just rip you apart if they really didn't like something. So again, you know, we hope that creators take test runs very seriously, because we evaluate it, we let you know, and then we put it up on the site, and it sits there for 30 days. And you have every ability to get people to check it out, because we're not going to evaluate it as being awesome. We're going to evaluate it for being competent and things like that. And then it's up to people who come to the site and post comments to tell us via the data that we look at whether or not they actually liked it. So you want to try to get as many people there as possible so you can check out the site, check out your story, and post a comment. So I hope that answers that question from that. We have, let's see here, Stu Lananas is posting, he's posting some great artwork in our group. Let's see here. We then have a comment here from Andre Roberts, who's writing, what type of art level are you looking for, MMWOG, which is a massively multiplayer World of Ghosts? And, you know, Andre, this is really not the place, I think, to talk about that aspect of it, because, you know, we're just not interested, and that's just not something I think that we need to try to promote in terms of looking for the series. I mean, I can say that, you know, I think we've always been very upfront about the way we view creators who are part of our content of Saturday AM. And so from that perspective, you know, we just look for creators who are competent. I think, for example, I'm a huge fan of David Yoon and Spoon. I think that Spoon is just literally one of our best series. And Spoon, artistically, for some people, is not, you know, as strong as White Manga stuff. I look at it and just see a unique style, and so that's why I'm so proud and happy that we run with it, because the story is really fantastic. It's one of our best ones. In fact, I'm clicking on Spoon now. So, you know, it's all about just the artist's ability to be competent in storytelling, and then the artist's own dedication and focus, and whether or not it kind of fits the flow of the sort of story that we're trying to tell of Mass Multiplayer World of Ghosts. One of the mistakes I made with Mass Multiplayer World of Ghosts is I tried to have the story told in the method of the creator, which you want to try to do on with the artist, I mean. You want to try to do that on some levels, but at the end of the day, the story should really have its own identity regardless of the artist. And once you have once you establish that through the writing and you really focus on that, then it really forces the artist to have to step up to the plate and match you versus you trying to match them. So again, there's really not anything I can tell you from the standpoint of what type of artist we're looking for from MWOG. And you know, like I said, we'll be soliciting people for it at some point here in the future. And if that's you, then you know, we'll certainly take a look at it. But I love the fact that you're excited about Mass Multiplayer World of Ghosts. We're not done with it, so it's definitely coming back, I can tell you that. It will be in Saturday Wars, by the way. All right, so I'm just checking here. I'm trying to see if there's any other comments. I'm going to start wrapping things up. Like I said, it's 1:17, so I'll give it about another 10, 12 minutes. So again, if you have comments, if you have questions, feel free to contact us. If you haven't subscribed, again, let me just reiterate that that's the biggest way you can support us is subscribe. You will pay more for this coffee I've got at Starbucks than you will just in terms of gas and buying the coffee than you will for 20 issues of Saturday AM. And I think at this point, we certainly don't have anything to prove on that front since we delivered 20 issues last year and we are on issue 32 this year with almost with about 5 months to go. No, 4 months to go, sorry. And we are just 8 issues away. We come out bi-weekly. So, you know, subscribe. It's only $5 a year. If you don't want to subscribe and you just want to check it out, you can pay $1.99. You're going to get upwards of anywhere from 30 to 70 to 100 to nearly 200 pages of content, just depending on what all we've got situated that month, that issue. But either way, you know, it's the content is worth it. If you were to buy Walking Dead on Comixology, that is a fantastic book. Robert Kirkman is a master storyteller. Charlie Adlard is a fantastic artist. Walking Dead is a phenomenon. The comic book is every bit as good, if not better, than the TV show. If you were to buy an issue of Walking Dead, it would cost you $2.99 for roughly about a 30-page book. We're at $1.99, and we usually have a hell of a lot more pages than that, including stuff that's color. So, you know, Walking Dead, the comic book's black and white digitally as well. So, you know, yeah, we kind of, you know, some of our, we have a lot more stuff in color, some of our interviews and stuff. So, yeah, I mean, this is, you know, you would be supporting us tremendously if you either buy an issue, buy a back issue or two, subscribe for $5, or subscribe at the ultimate level for $25 and get that early access to Saturday Plus, get the T-shirt. We're going to have exclusive tutorials soon, you know, limited edition trading cards, you name it. It's just, how can you turn that down? And here are all the back issues. Look at all that beautiful artwork. Like I said, people can take pot shots at us all day long, but I don't know anyone else who's delivered this many issues consistently in this much time with this much quality artwork of artists that, for frankly, have never been seen before, most of them. You've not seen any of these guys on Marvel, DC, Image, or Viz, and these are all of our guys. And this is why we take very seriously being Saturday AM. We're proud of it. All right, so I think we've got one more question here. Let me see what we got here. So Andre Roberts asked regarding Test Run. He says, if someone submits a test run and we think it's okay to be published, and so we publish it on our website in the test run section, and it does not get a lot of viewership or comments from people, you know, from us running it on the site, do we think it has a chance for publication in the future? And the answer is, of course. The answer is that we look at a variety of metrics that are proprietary. We don't reveal those metrics, but we look at a variety of data points to tell us whether or not something has a chance for success. It doesn't mean it will, but you know, we're very proud of the series that we have. Again, Spoon looks totally different than Apple Black. And if you were a company that has Apple Black, and someone who draws like Spoon approached you, you know, there's a chance, frankly, in the traditional comic industry, in manga, and in webcomics, that you would say, no, I want more stuff that looks like Apple Black and not stuff that looks like Spoon. And, you know, again, our commitment to diversity is demonstrated because we don't care about those issues. We care about the creator. We care about the concept. We care about the genre and its place within the landscape of Saturday M. And so we look at a lot of data points and just getting comments or getting lots of traffic are not the only indicators that we look at. And that's something, again, that I'm very proud of, and it's worked tremendously for us. We have Islanders today. We have Comet Man today from two creators who had never produced a webcomic before and did it through Pilot Manga, and we now have these great series that come through there. We're Medium Plus, had never been done before, went through Pilot Manga. We now publish for Medium Plus. So there's definitely an opportunity there that we look at. It has nothing to do with those things. So let's see here. So I think there's another comment here. Yes, there's another comment here. So again, if you've got questions, shoot them through because we're running out of time here. And I'm getting sleepy. And I'm drinking coffee and I'm still getting sleepy. I think Elijah Duncan is talking to Andre Roberts. He's saying, man, you still didn't help me with my story. How are you going to audition for Master Multiplayer World of Ghosts? So, so that's pretty good. So, all right. So I think that's it. I don't think there's any other questions there. So I'm going to power it down here in terms of the screen share. Bring it back to this very pretty face here. You can see here I'm very tired. You can see here the coffee hasn't kept me up totally because I'm really about to crash. Damn, so good. So good. Learn to embrace coffee, ladies and gentlemen. Learn to embrace coffee. So, again, Saturday AM t-shirt. You subscribe at the premium level, you get this for free. Apple Black, if you buy this on our website, not any other website like Amazon, our website, www.saturday-am.com, $8. You buy this beautiful Saigami book, it's just $6. That is almost as inexpensive as a Shueisha, a Shonen Jump book. If you subscribe, you get the t-shirt, you get some of the trading cards. I don't have the trading cards on me. And you also get this bad boy. Exclusive artwork that you will not see anywhere else. And on the back of it, the code that you can use to get discounts on select things. Also, to be admitted into tutorials that we'll do. So one of the things we're going to be announcing soon is that we're going to do tutorials exclusively through for subscribers of premium. So if you are a premium subscriber and you don't want to go through test flight and you don't want to go through test run, we will set up a tutorial for you that only you can view it, and we'll also do critiques. Not multiple critiques, but we'll do a critique for each premium subscriber, at least one specific just your comic book critique without having to go through test flight. So that's a pretty big deal. We're pretty excited about that. So that's, you know, pretty much it. So just to recap again, our commitment for Saturday AM, when I started this company, the entire idea was about diversity. And we have it. We have, you know, several people of color. We are starting to get more and more women involved. And we have people from all over the world. And so the concepts, the comics that they produce feel original and different because they're not from Japan and they're not, you know, the standard individual from the West Coast or from a major city in America. These are people from all over the world, from Nigeria to Hungary to New Jersey and so on, Maryland. We will be... if you are a member of Pilot Manga, not only do you get to officially submit your comic story through either our test flight competition or our test run competition, but you will be considered, if you enter those things, potentially for inclusion in our original graphic novel, crossover event with all of our characters called Saturday Wars. And it's going to be huge. It comes out in 2016. You'll also be featured in our trading card set. And if you're an artist and you're in Pilot Manga and you want to create a t-shirt design and we carry it exclusively and it sells, you will get money for that. So, you know, tonight has been about talking about Test Flight and Test Run. The Test Flight reveal that we gave tonight is that the rules will go live on September 16th, and the entire idea of that particular Test Flight, the big thing that you win is that we're going to select winners of that who will go into a special Saturday AM Christmas special that will be exclusive to Comixology, the number one digital web comic book site in the world. And we'll have a special Saturday AM special that'll feature a lot of our top creators, and you potentially will be sitting right next to them. You can have your friends buy it, or you'll have a couple of free copies you can give to people. But that's huge. You get to actually get published inside of Saturday AM for just participating in a Test Flight and doing a good job and having a really cool concept. We also addressed this concept of haters and the silliness of haters. And, you know, I'll just say again that if you're spending that much time trying to knock me or knock this company, that does not speak well about you. You know, our objective, you know, is to bring more diversity to the table, and is to try to create a pathway for webcomics to be taken seriously and to be a money-making endeavor so that everybody, whether you like us or not, whether you're in Saturday or not, but you're a manga webcomic creator, can benefit. You know, all it takes is for one webcomic brand to break through, and then everyone associated with webcomics will feel the benefit of it in some way. So if you're a hater, my suggestion to you is stop being a hater. You know, it's late. That's the best I can tell you. Clock Striker, our first black female lead character, one of the only black female lead manga characters I can think of, major characters I can think of, is out now. It'll run for issue 32, 33, and 34. So this coming Saturday we'll see part two of that story, so I hope you check it out. We're incredibly proud of the response we got. At some point I will tell the story of a spat I got into with a founder of a major anime site who I think just typifies why I started my footprint in Saturday AM in the first place, because he had the general idea that I and other people of color who don't like the fact that manga does not feature a lot of people of color, or if they do it in a very stereotypical way, that somehow what we needed to do was just get over it because the Japanese are not going to change. And again, I've studied in Japan, I've been in Japan, I've done business with the Japanese officially. Just seems so stupid to say that unless you actually know what you're talking about. And this guy, to be the founder of a major anime site in America, to say something so blatantly ignorant is beyond me. And like I told him, if it's true, then he owes it to his own journalistic integrity to put the Japanese creators, to name them, to have them say, yes, I don't care about black people. I don't care about Latino people. I don't think they're going to do that. I know you don't think they're going to do that. I've dealt with the Japanese. They're truly some of the most loveliest people in the world. Can't imagine for life me that they would actually do that. But this one white male individual had that impression. And this is why diversity is so important. Because when we're not at the table, and by we I just mean everybody who's not, you know, the traditional either white male or Japanese mangaka, when we're not at the table with our own concepts, our own ideas, and our own voices, when we're not at the table, then they begin to believe that the world that they view in terms of how they see it is the real world, and it's not. This individual, this editor, the founder of this website, cannot speak for Japanese mangaka. And like I said, if he could, and if he's going to be a journalist and have integrity, then he'll name who these guys are who supposedly do not care about black and Latino people. Furthermore, having been in Japan, I know that they don't have a problem with me. They have no problem with Michael Jordan. They have no problem with Eddie Murphy. They have no problem with lots of black celebrities. President Obama is very popular there. So this idea that they don't know about black culture is ridiculous. They know who Beyonce is. They listen to Beyonce's music. They love hip-hop more than some white people. So it's astonishing that, again, this one white male is taking his very limited view and prescribing it for everybody. And he can try to hide behind the idea that this was just, you know, an editorial. But as I said before, I started this company because I saw that type of thinking too frequently. When you have industries that are dominated by just white men and Asian men or Asian women, which the anime industry in America is, then you find yourself in a position where you have unintended racial consequences. By the way, whether or not you think that's true, there's a whole element that we have called Silicon Valley, and this is a discussion going on right now in Silicon Valley. And Silicon Valley is liberal, it's progressive, it's largely Democrat, and yet they still have some of the worst racial integration that in these companies that's existed. And it's because, again, this is the same people who start these companies. They staff it with people who look and think like them. And as a result, they live in a bubble of what they expect to happen. And we started Saturday AM to challenge that idea. And unless you're trying to challenge that idea, then you're part of the problem. You're not part of the solution, because the world is diverse. You can't ask me to pay for Naruto or Attack on Titan or any of these manga and support that creator when he can create content and literally just imagine that I don't exist. That's not fair to millions of people who are putting money in their pockets. And so we intend to do something about that. Again, that's part of this whole revolution. Some people won't like that. I don't care. We're doing something that I feel confident about and feel good about, for my daughter, for my nephew, for young kids of color, young people, young women, young people of different sexual orientation, young people of different nationalities, young people who simply don't feel that they are part of the equation in traditional Japanese manga or the kind of white male media complex built around Japanese manga. We are doing this for all those other people. And again, you know, if you support that idea and what that idea can wrought, which is more diversity, more positive, original ideas, hopefully less antagonism like we see, particularly in America right now, with people who look like me getting shot by the police, you would think that having more diversity in manga, in comic books, in movies, in TV, will help to demystify the look of the black male or the minority, so that people don't fear us. So, again, you know, we're not doing this for our health. We're not doing this for our bank account. We're doing this for very real reasons. We believe in it. We sacrifice for it. We've bled for this. We have lost money building this, and we have fans all over the world. We have an amazing outpouring of support. We're covering our bills that we get for this company, and we're doing it because you guys have supported us. Thank you for supporting us. It means more to us than you'll ever know. We're going to continue to do really innovative and revolutionary things. We're going to continue to grow. We're not going anywhere. And I want to thank you guys for supporting us. If you have already subscribed to us, but you want to continue to try to support us, just tell people about us. Tweet about us, hashtag us, share our social media profiles to people. Social media buttons that we do or plugs that we do for our upcoming content, and retweet them, reshare them on Facebook or Twitter. We really appreciate it. That's the only way that we continue to grow and be something substantial in this place. But that's it. That's all the questions I see. I'm going to check one last thing, see if there's any questions there. I don't think there is. No, there's no questions there. And there are, let's see here. There's no questions here. It's just a kind of back and forth by Andre and Elijah. So that's it. So, again, everybody, I really want to appreciate you guys taking time out this Friday night. Saturday night, you could have been watching TOONAMI, but you supported us, and I really appreciate that. Saturday AM issue number 33 and Saturday Plus issue number 10 come out this coming Saturday next weekend. And it's going to be great. More Clock Striker. Apple Black returns, by the way. And more Tomy Life, more Explosion Joe, more Chain Black. You can't go wrong with that. We'll be announcing more Saturday tanks like Bully Eater very soon, and they'll have pre-orders set up as well. I can tell you the next one will be Z Forever, and we've got Spoon and Storybook in the offing, and somewhere distant will be Islanders. And we're going to be introducing next weekend as well more items in the marketplace, our official store. One of them, by the way, is going to be a shirt that is not connected to Saturday AM, but I promise you it will be a shirt that you will want to wear in this election season. So that's it. Guys, thank you so much for spending your time with me. I so appreciate it. We are here to support you, and we're here because of you. So thank you for believing us. Those of you who support us, the haters of you in the world, you guys need to get a friend. Peace out.